Hello and welcome to episode 15 of Let's Play Civilization 6. In the intro-turn, after I stopped recording, I did some cleanup, so I got Natal and I also got my peace with Pedro. So I've pretty much done my conquest, I think, of the Brazilians. They're, stuck to this one city, I think. And we now have land borders touching with Preslav, and we're within striking distance of Nanmadal. So, it doesn't really matter if I have access to those two cities or not, but it's always better to be able to defend them and, have contiguous land borders with them than not. So, I guess our next target would be China, and at this point, I feel like we've kind of made our bed in terms of diplomatic relations. So if the world doesn't like us very much, we might as well go all out and do what we need to do. I noticed that there's oil here, just right outside the border of this territory that they just ceded to us. But when I tried buying the tile, it's just right outside our range, so we couldn't get that, quite get that. Obviously, there's oil here, and there's also a patch of oil right here, so we'll see. We did get oil as as part of the peace from the Congolese. And we'll see how that goes for now. So we'll just need to consolidate. We have a bunch of new trade routes open to us because of all the recent conquests we've made. Let's see here, how bad are the war weirdness here? No war weirdness for that? Oh yeah, because they ceded that city to us, I think. Is there any war weirdness here? No war weirdness here either. Okay, we're good. So we also captured a builder that was floating around here. I think one of the barbarians captured it, so we're just going to use that to improve our territory around here. I don't know how many builds they have left here. Maybe only one build left. Yeah. I do have our naturalists. I want to see if I can I want to see if I can make a national park. I still haven't quite figured out how that mechanic works. Okay, we got our Cold War promotion.
If you go on with this nuclear arms race, all you're gonna do is make the rubble bounce.
Let's get computers done. Let's rebase this to here. I like this feature where you can set your fighters to patrol a specific area. So we're gonna deploy it and patrol near this Chinese capital city. I think that's where I'm gonna hit up next. Okay, I've linked my Grand Admiral with my battleship. Okay, we got three sources of uranium. I think they're all three under are all under our districts, our cities, so we have access to them right away. Builder we captured only had one build left, so it's gone now.
If winning isn't everything, why do they keep score?
Let's look at our trade routes. So we will rebase this trade route to transfer to Los Angeles. Finish the Cold War. Let's do another trader here. Okay. Like that.
If you do not...
This is good. Enemy spy levels reduced by 2. I'm gonna switch to that when I get a chance. Alright, and I forgot to move my naturalist. I wanna see if I can make a national park here somewhere.
From Stettin in the Baltic to Trieste in the Adriatic, an iron curtain has descended across the continent.
Nuclear plant going here. We're gonna get a bunch of nuclear plants going here to speed up production. Do an encampment. Okay, we'll buy a worker as well. I keep saying worker, I meant builder. Where is our naturalist? Let's move it over here. Thank you. Oh, this is a tank. Okay, I can't relink those. Can I upgrade to any more tanks? I'm really surprised how few units there are in this game now. You can whittle down your army down to a few essential units. I don't know if this is the right way to play though, but we'll see. Trade route. I like that it's sorted by destination.
There's so much plastic in this culture that vinyl leopard skin is becoming an endangered synthetic.
Plus one gold, plus two influence. Yeah, I want to keep these. Should I swap out a wild card? Let me swap this out. I think we don't need gold as much right now. Let's get another trader out. Can't do it? I'm completely lost how this mechanic works. I have to figure that out. let's do that. Okay, we're just giving them our extras. Not gonna hurt us very much. I was reading on the forums that really you only get the benefit of the first luxury you have, so if you have multiple copies, there's no point hoarding them. I had misunderstood the intent, because each luxury is supposed to give you 4 amenities, so I thought if you had 2 copies of the same luxuries, then technically you could get up to 8, right? One for each city. And, you know, the one copy will give you up to 4 cities, 2 will up to 8, but apparently it's really, it all goes into a pool, and only the first copy counts, so I'm gonna start trading some of those away eventually. Someone just siphoned 1,000 gold from us. I wonder who. Send that back to Washington. So I need to find out who's been stealing my gold. It's probably not a Chinese. Gandhi? Possible. Pericles? Possible too. Actually, I think it's him, because I just siphoned gold from him and he immediately had 1,000 gold.
All material things seem to have been composed of the hard and solid particles, variously associated with the first creation by the counsel of an intelligent agent.
Never mind the maneuvers, just go straight at them.
Okay, we'll send that to Washington, and we'll... Okay. promote this unit. I guess I have to wait until that mission is over. Let's get another traitor out. So let me do the power plant now. Well, interesting, we still don't have Casus Belli to attack China for doing that. Someone sabotaged my industrial zone. I'm thinking it's a Chinese. Up national parks again, or yeah, national parks. Oh, it has to be 4 contiguous hexes, so how does that work? let's check the appeal. I guess 1, 2, 3, but there's a bank here. Charming. And it's, I think it has to be breathtaking or higher, right? Oh, charming or better. All four talismans must be owned by the same city. Talismans must form a diamond shape. Oh, that's very tricky. So it has to be like this, 1, 2, 3, 4. That's a diamond shape, that's a park right there. Because there's really no place I can do that right now. Okay. Oh no, I'm not gonna give you all that stuff for a piddly little amount of gold. I bet he's been waiting forever to do that.
Many rules had begun to bend at the hand of nanotechnology. This produced a lot of good and a lot of bad.
Carl Sagan, of course I'll get him. Space race construction, okay. I'm gonna get some more bombers out. Rest in here. Too sure. Oh, Valletta is now. I'm suzerain of Valletta. Or is it just because of the trade route? Let me see here. Yeah, I am suzerain. That's weird. I only have 3 envoys. Oh, it says 3 or more I can be suzerain, because there's no one else competing with me, obviously. Or there is, but they're too low. That's great. Let's keep working on that. What do they want from us? Train a biplane. Well, I can't do that. I can't. That quest should be cancelled after a while, because I'm way past a biplane now. This needs to be patched, I think, because the AI is sticking to their outdated armies. I could totally crush them if I were to attack right now. And I think the AI thinks I'm going to attack here, because they have all their units here, but actually I want to attack here, where they don't have any units. Yeah, if I were to put my commercial next to my harbor, I'd actually get a +3 gold. So, my next playthrough, I need to plan that a little bit better. Brazil. Do we now have an armada here? Thank you. One of my economics policies became outdated, so let's see what I can use. All captured. Disappointing. That's the one I was going to promote to. I did want to talk to the Chinese about stopping the spy on me. Still no. No civs are on good terms in this game, which is interesting. Okay.
When God said, "Let there be light," he surely must have meant perfectly coherent light.
Oh, we lose Suzerain where? Oh, Valletta? Okay. Who is, Petra at war with? Oh, Pericles. Okay, so I think this is a good place to end the video. Thank you very much for watching. I will see you next time. Bye.